Good morning, children. Welcome to Harleen Ma'am's class. And you all are so loved. And very soon, we're going to be back in school. Come on, Andy. What are we going to do today? Grade 6, Chapter 2, In Morning Dew by KK Daruwala. Are we all ready, Grade 6? Good morning, children. Welcome to my class, Grade 6, Images in Morning Dew. Children, do you know what a scarecrow is? Something like this? A scarecrow? All right. Today, we're going to do this poem. Children, a scarecrow is a figure made by the farmers to guard his fields so that all the birds and animals get scared and they think there's a real person there and they don't come and eat up his crop. Should we start? In Morning Dew. Now, first connect, reflect and imagine, everybody. Have you ever had a riot of questions in your head and no one to give you answers? So many questions. Where do the seasons come from? How does it become morning, night? Yes? Who makes the question papers? Right? Where did all this come from? What happened? How does this machine work? How do we have internet? How does this whole thing, technology, work? So many questions in our mind. The same way, the scarecrow in this poem is the main character and he wonders, you know, how these seasons come and go, but there's nobody to answer his questions. Well, imagine for a day you become a scarecrow and you are in the field. It's made by farmers, you know, with a pot as a head, you know, loose shirt and pair of pants and some straw hanging around. You have to draw yourself as a scarecrow and tell the class what you see all around you for a day. So imagine you're a scarecrow and do the imagine part. Have you ever wondered how it would be to be a scarecrow? Let's read this poem and find out. In morning dew, the scarecrow combs his hair. In morning light, the scarecrow looks so spry. You know, he's had a good night's sleep. He's now in a fitter state to spy on shouting monkeys and the porcupine. He gets to see everything all the time, except his shadow, which lazes about till the evening snuffs the fellow out. In the first stanza, the poet is telling us that the scarecrow has had a good night's sleep. It's a non-living thing. And he combs his hair because of the morning dew. What is morning dew? Right in the morning, you have those little tiny droplets of water. And he is looking very alert. Yes, and you know he's had a very good sleep because he's fitter, he's alert, and he's ready to spy on all the birds and insects and the animals around, on shouting monkeys and porcupine. He gets to see everything all the time because he's standing in the fields all day long, morning, evening, night. Thunder, rain, whatever, storm. He's always standing in the field and guarding the crops. Except he can't see his shadow, which lazes about. Can you see your shadow? He cannot see his shadow till the evening snuffs the fellow out. And at night, what happens as the evening goes? You cannot see your shadow. Yes, because the sun is not there. And the poor fellow doesn't have a shadow. It disappears in the evening. We move on to the second stanza. Whether he sees the seasons come and go is a thing you and I may never know. But busy as he is, he keeps an eye on all the bird traffic passing by. Some questions always bother him. How seasons come and go? The way the seasons to and fro. He doesn't know who's getting in. Summer, autumn, or the snow. Something he should surely know. In the second stanza, my dear children, the poet is telling us from the point of view of the scarecrow that, you know, his head is really, you know, he's wondering where do the seasons come? You know, how does it become summers and winters and autumn and spring and snow? It's a thing you and I may never know. But he's very busy. He keeps an eye on all the bird traffic, all the birds which are passing by. And some questions are always troubling him. Some questions trouble you also all the time. How seasons come and go. The way the seasons to and fro, he doesn't know which season's coming in and going. Is it a summer? Is it the autumn? Or is it the winter? Because he's always there. Something he should surely know. We move on to the third stanza, my dear children. He knows he shivers in the cold, and in the summer he will fry with the heat. Do seasons come up from the ground, or do they drop down from the sky? Are questions that have bothered him. Answers do not dribble in. To keep questions out and answers in, he bolts his upper story's door. Then he wonders why on earth his head goes round in circles, for while seasons circle round and round like oxen on a threshing floor. In the last stanza, the poet is telling us that the scarecrow is always there on the fields, you know, whether it's cold, he shivers. In the summer, he fries because of the heat. And he wonders, do the seasons just pop up from the ground, or do they fall from the sky? Are questions that have bothered him, that have troubled him. And answers are not coming in into his upper story. This is his upper story. So what he does is, he bolts it. He locks it up, you know, and he wonders, why on earth does it head keeps going round in circles when the seasons circle round and round? Seasons come in circles. So he wonders how his head is going round and round, just like an oxen on a threshing floor. On the fields, how an oxen, when he's threshing or he's plowing, how he goes round and round, just like that. His head is going round and round in circles, wondering how the seasons come and go. Well, I hope you all have understood the poem. A little bit on K.K. Daruwala is a contemporary Indian English writer and a poet. In his poem, the speaker looks at the world through the eyes of the scarecrow. He sees monkeys and birds, porcupines, and observes them. He notices them. But even the scarecrow is perplexed. He's confused. He's troubled. He's startled by the seasons. He wonders where they come from, how they affect him, and where they go. All right, moving on to the multiple choice. In the morning dew, night sleep, A, B, or C. The correct answer is, in the morning dew, night sleep, the dew settles in the scarecrow's hair and he looks untidy. He gets to see, but something lazes out. Yes, the scarecrow is not able to see his shadow. Till the evening snuffs the fellow out. What happens in the evening? The shadow disappears at sunset. Whether he sees them, he will never know. We will never find out what the scarecrow notices because it's a non-living thing. He has no life. Some questions he surely wants to know. The first answer, the scarecrow is worried that he doesn't know in what order the seasons are coming, how they follow each other. Two seasons, of course, have bothered him. A question that bothers the scarecrow is whether seasons drop from the sky or whether they rise up from the ground. Answers do not come, so he bolts his upper story. What does he do? Answers don't come because the scarecrow cannot think and he cannot find answers to anything. So he just bolts, he locks his upper story and his head is like an oxen on a threshing floor. The scarecrow doesn't understand the world around him. So he just bolts them. I hope the poem is clear to you, my dear children. Yes, sometimes when we do not get the answers to certain questions, it really bothers us. It really troubles us. However, sometimes we are afraid to ask questions because we feel it might be foolish. You know, it's not a really apt question. Maybe I'm just being foolish. How come I don't know? But no, you should never keep doubts in your mind and ask them out. Why, when, where, how? Ask these questions in your curious mind. And don't worry about people laughing at you. They are fools who don't ask questions. So you need to ask your questions. Yes, where, why, what happened? Why is it like this? How does this work? So that you, your curious mind has answers to all. All right. Thank you, children. Love you all.